Tom Stewart was lucky. Too lucky. His engine trouble was too convenient. He was back on the carrier safe in his bunk while we were fighting for our lives against the 13th Squadron. The other pilots were furious. They wanted his blood. They found Stewart in his bunk. They pulled him out, screaming traitor, Jap lover, and worse. Callahan and I could barely stop them from stringing him up right there. We got him out of there and back to Callahan's room. Tom pleaded with us. He promised he wasn't a traitor, that he hadn't sold us out to the Japs. I wanted to believe him, but there was part of me that wasn't sure. But the other guys, they wouldn't fly with him anymore. And even if he did fly with us again, he'd be likely to get a tail full of U.S.-issue bullets. Callahan grounded him and took his wings away. He said it was for Stewart's own safety, but I think it was for all our sakes. Earlier, during the recon mission, I'd taken out an ace called Taiki Hasegawa from the 13th. I'd fought three of their top guys, but I still hadn't had a chance to fly against Shunagawa. The Japanese commander at Betio Island had promised it would take a million men 100 years to take Tarawa. Rear Admiral Shibasaki, the commander there, had spent years fortifying the island. He'd put in new layered defenses that gave mutual support. When we did land there, after just a few hours of bombing, our Marines were cut to pieces by the Japs. The first wave suffered almost total casualties. Eventually, we took the island, but not before we lost 1,500 men. The Japs lost over three times that many. Tarawa was a learning experience for us, a lesson in how not to take an island from the Japanese. The rest of 43 was quiet. We all pulled our fleets back for repairs and refitting. Back home, though, things weren't quiet. Our factories were running at full speed. Back then, we churned out 7,000 planes a month, compared to just 1,500 that the Japanese could produce. It wasn't just planes, though. Our shipyards were also running full tilt. Since the start of the war, we'd produced 500 destroyers and escorts. With a shortage of raw materials, the Japs could barely manage 30.
Just received an urgent radio message from our top agent, codenamed Usurper. After infiltrating a secret Japanese airbase and retrieving vital war plans, Usurper escaped by stealing a Japanese seaplane Zero called Roof. Unfortunately, his aircraft took several hits and he has made a forced landing. The Japanese will be looking for him too. You are to take a PBY Catalina and rescue him. We can guide you into the area of Usurper's last transmission. Usurper will fire a red flare to guide you to his exact location. Pick him up and return to base. His information could save many lives, Lieutenant.
Two of the Jap carriers that hit us at Pearl Harbor were stationed at Marianas. We were heading into one hell of an air battle.
Okay, Lieutenant. Our last radio contact with Usurper was from bearing 305. Suggest you climb to search altitude and proceed north-northeast.
No problem, Hornet. Let me just ease this big mama off the water. to keep their eyes peeled. I want to hear about it immediately if you spot anything.
Boss, either we gotta pick off the Japs from a distance or run like hell. I wouldn't want to be dogfighting in this old sow.
Sir, I can see a flare.
We'll need to take those cruisers out before we can pick them up, and fast.
Let me grab my kit, and I'll be right on board.
Lord have mercy. What the hell is that?
It's a Japanese carrier sub.
Look at the size of the monster. Come on, we have to get the hell out of here.
Come on!
information was more important than I thought.
Yeah, suck on that, Tojo.
If I've ever seen it, I'll be telling your CO about this.
Lieutenant. Are you okay to land?
Oh, there are a lot of holes, but this big mama's still watertight. Or we'll be able to keep her floating for a while yet.
Put her down next to the cruisers and we'll get one of them to winch you aboard for repairs.
Thanks for the little home, Lieutenant Crow. You really saved my bacon today. If I've ever seen it, I'll be telling your CEO about this.
like you had a tough flight, Lieutenant. Are you okay to land?
Oh, there are a lot of holes, but this Big Mama's still watertight. Or we'll be able to keep her floating for a while yet.
Put her down next to the cruisers and we'll get one of them to winch you aboard for repairs.
Thanks for the little home, Lieutenant Crow. You really saved my bacon today.